although this bill, it shows that it is a very innocuous bill, but from the clause 2A, it appears that the government wants to take away the powers of the civil courts. And here it is said that no injunction shall be granted by a court in a suit under this Act involving a contract relating to an infrastructure project where granting injunction would cause impediment or delay in the progress of completion of such infrastructure project. Now, who will decide that whether it will create impediment to any infrastructure project, government or the court? If we want to respect the rule of law so far practiced in this country, then it is under the purview of the court. If an aggrieved person, where he will go? If government decides, no, we cannot allow this because it will create impediment to infrastructure structure, then that is final. I have no remedy to go to the civil court. This is number one. This is very dangerous for democracy, sir. Number two, the list, the schedule which has been mentioned here, that is not exhaustive, because what is it is said in clause 20A, sub clause 2, it is said that the central government may, depending upon the requirement, amend the schedule relating to any category of projects or infrastructure or subsection. Therefore, subsequently also, government assumes the power to incorporate any project under that schedule. This is another dangerous provision. And finally, sir, in clause 20B, it is proposed that the state government, in consultation with the Chief Justice, etc., will establish one or more civil courts as special courts. My question is that in this country, how many special courts will be created in this way? And in the process, the normal civil courts will be defunct. Therefore, I would urge the government to have a revisit and relook to this provision, and I am opposed to this bill.
Thank you.